away last year at the age of 96. And it focuses on sustainable and replicable solutions. Now, Chitrakoot Pura has made 500 villages as self-reliant, Swavlambi. They call it Swavlamban. So Swavlambi means self-reliant. And we were there in February 2011 when 500 villages, they inaugurated this model for that. And it's very interesting, you know, the parameters for self-reliance are very interesting, and they go beyond just economic things, you know. Of course, there is economic activity, which is 18,000 rupees per annum should be the minimum salary for everyone in the village, for every family in the village. And each family should have its own house. They should own the house. And there should be no unemployed rural youth, physical connect. There should be a road leading to the village. Then there should be, all the children should have an access to the schools and other public amenities. The last point is most interesting. Social consciousness and harmony. Now, how do you measure that? They derived a set of criteria for measuring social consciousness. I'll just tell you a few of them. One of them is, no widow should be denied remarriage. The society should not discriminate against a widow. She should be allowed to remarry if she wants to. And then another interesting one is, there should be no internal litigation within the villages. So, aapas mein ek dusre pe mukadma nahi hona chahiye. You know, they should not have litigation against each other. And they have achieved this profile for 500 villages. That's a lot of people. How do they do that? Besides the other things I'll talk about in the next slide as well, but just quickly, the most important element of any rural development actually, which is the greatest lesson which comes out of Chitrakoot, is the human touch. You cannot do a planning at 40,000 feet and execute it. You need to have people at 0 feet. And these are the people. These are the people. This is called a Samaj Shilp Dampati. If I would translate to you in English, that would mean social sculpturing couples. Yeah, social sculpturing couples. And these are young graduate couples. Both of them are graduate. The lady and the man, both are graduate. They should not have more than 2 children, so 2 or less. And they live within those villages. In the whatever community places are there, they live it. They are entirely supported by the villagers. The DRI also, the Deen Dayal Research Institute, the Pura, also pays them some amount, but much of their daily activities, their needs are taken care by the villages. They're given a cycle, this is the cycle, and they are the ones who would go out to villages, do public appraisal, find out what they need, and tell them that this is right, this is wrong, this is how you should do it, this is a better way of doing it, and they live with them. And that's the key, because that's when they are able to relate to their problems, and that is where they are able to convince them in a better manner, much better than I would. So this has been, and this is a 5-year fellowship kind of a program, after which they will be absorbed in a, and they are implementing this model. Besides them, the other things, there's a PPP initiative called Krishi Vigyan Kendras. I'm not sure whether you're aware of it. It basically means rural Vigyan, rural science centers. There are 2 of them which DRI is operating. One is in Manjgawa and the other is in Ganivan. And they have an area of 113 acres under them, which help the farmer by hands-on approach on how to improve their farming practices. There are scientists over there, there are farmers over there. And the most important, this I'll show you, and I'll come back to the previous slide. This is one of the boards which we have put at it is at Manjgawa. The Manjgawa KVK, this is a board. Now, this fellow, it is a 1.5 acre what to do. So these are the kind of things which you can grow. And this is the kind of revenue, which this is the kind of yield which you can get out of it. And this is again for, this one is for 2.5 acres. And what you need to grow. And what happens is that at this particular KVK, Krishi Vigyan Kendra, the farm size is, the lot size is 1.5 and 2.5. And there are many such blocks. And the farmers are called there. So you come there, you do an internship kind of a thing for two weeks, 3 weeks, whatever. The reason why 1.5 or 2.5 acre is chosen is because that is the average land holding size of the farmer over there. You know, you show them that this is what you can do in your village. Yahi kar sakte ho. Tumhare jaisa to khet hai. Same size, same characteristics. You can do it in your place as well. And you are doing it right here for 2 weeks. Why can't you do the same thing in your village, in your own farm? and you can yield all these things in your farm. And that's how the hands-on approach, instead of, you know, instead of telling them from a loud, this is what you can do, ye karo, wo karo, aisa karo, we tell them, this is what you have done and this is what you can do, this is your competency. So this is the thing which I wanted to point out. Besides that, there is an Udyamita Vidyapeet, which is a sort of an incubation center, which has about a dozen shops. Each shop is basically a factory, and each factory produces something end to end. And people come there, they get, they engage into the production process, and then they carry a certificate with them, which we, they also help them with the microfinancing part if they want to start up. So this is the rural incubation center. This particular photograph is that of a very beautiful aerial view of Arogya Dham, which is a sort of, it's an Ayurved-based healthcare for the villages. And much of the products coming out of it are based on the locally available herbs. So people can do that. And it's one of the best FDA-approved rasshalas, which is, I'll just move on because we don't have time. Very recent Pura, one of the latest ones, not the latest one, but one of the latest one, has been set up by Periyar Mannamai University, and with the help of a lot of other local agencies in a place called Tanjur, Vallam. So that's in South India. And it's called Periyar Pura. It covers about 7 blocks. Each block has a kind of a competency of its own. So someone is making coconut-based products, someone is making alternative building material, and likewise. So this is when it was inaugurated. 2003 it was inaugurated. Boss is there. And it's been growing ever since. Quickly move on. This is the alternative building material workshop which runs there. And these are some of the details. There's no time. The slide you can probably is available on the website, www.abdulkalam.com. You can download it from there. Now I wanted to quickly get into the next thing, which is something, what ahead. And that, this is called Pura Activated. And this is basically, up till now we were more into like independent Puras coming up, and then there was no sharing of technology between them, sharing of experiences between them, or sharing of even a brand between them. So this is what Pura Activated, which is now being set up under the vision of Dr. Kalam as a separate entity, is called Pura Activated, which will focus on integrated development and all these things which are there. But more importantly, it will bring all the Puras together. It will help spawn new Puras using three kinds of investments, which I'll talk about, and using two kinds of entrepreneurs, which is a resource entrepreneur and a social entrepreneur, so which are quite related with each other, especially in a rural context. So what does basically each, wherever Pura is being set up, we need a local champion, a local Pura champion, or a champion institution, which will be linked through the Pura Activated to each other. And these are the kind of things which will do, like doing technical assistance, financing, policy support, inter-Pura interaction, and the kind of people who are now working with Pura Activated are academicians, they are people from industry, media, all those people we are trying to get together to form this entire network of Pura Activated. Now, when we talk about enterprise development, this is the kind of integrated enterprise development model covered in one slide. So one is this, this is the product processing chain. So primary procurement to processing to marketing in local, horizontal, and export channels. But beyond that, we need to create entrepreneurs at rural levels which are knowledge entrepreneurs, which can provide knowledge to all these processes and facilitation, things like financing and savings and banking, wherever the Puras are being set up is needed. This I'll skip. Okay. So what are the three modes of contribution which can be done in Pura? One is knowledge, the other is investment, and the third is a market linkage. I'll quickly talk about what exactly is there. We call it the Pura Sehbag. Sehbag means cooperative kind of, cooperative. Pura Sehbag model, which is three kinds of Sehbag. Nivesh, which is basically about stock sizes of 1,000 rupees. We want to create a model where anyone and everyone can contribute. We want large scale of people to contribute into the Pura mission. So the investment size starts at 1,000 rupees. There's a hold period for the investment. After that, we try to link it as an equity investor kind of model with the local entrepreneur at the Pura level. This I'll skip. Okay, then we have a Gyan Sehbag model. Gyan means knowledge, Sehbag means cooperate. So some people might not or may not, especially the young students, researchers, these kind of young professionals, retirees, students, all these people might not be able to contribute in terms of investment, but we need much more than investment. We need knowledge. That's very, very important. And that's where the knowledge stock size of Pura also comes in. So people can contribute in terms of knowledge. The third is called market, yani vyapar, sehbag, which is basically based on building market linkages for the products which are coming out of Pura under the Pura brand, and individuals, professionals, NRIs, corporate, everyone can participate in it. And that is basically the Pura. All these three investment models will create something called the Pura social share stock, where each one corresponds to a social share. We want to create a composite social share of the three ingredients, which has to expand. So this will lead to the implementation of Pura in the future. So we are trying to bring them all together. And this is how typically a Pura now would, with integration, would move. Different Puras will be connected across a common brand, which will be managed by domain experts. And this is the kind of brand which we are trying to create for rural Indian products. Now, that's about the end. This is a photograph pretty close to Loni. Loni is a place near Shirdi Sai Baba, right? So it's pretty close to Loni. And this is where the Pura at Loni, there's a Pura at Loni as well, we was trying to expand. This picture captures a lot of things. There's this girl who is, if you notice, in her school uniform, and she's pulling a plow, hull. And this is the mother, and this is the father. This is where we need the intervention. You know, people at rural levels are very hardworking. They're talented, they're hardworking. All they need is one-time support. The Paliganj statement, which Dr. Kalam made, they don't need things for free. No one needs things for free. What is needed is empowerment. Empowerment through technology. The hull, look at the hull. That has to be technologically empowered. The girl has to be in school. Once that happens, the girl will be in school. The farm would be yielding much more than it is right now. And this is the kind of, when we talk about integrated models, this is what we need. Each thing leads into another. And this is what Pura aspires for. This is about 10 years old, this picture. And this brings us to the end, which is almost on time. I've delayed by 5 minutes. You can, since it's a huge topic, you can always write to me at srijan@abdulkalam.com if you want to know more. This is my mobile number, which is generally switched off. Then this is Dr. Kalam's email ID. He'll be happy to hear your ideas as well. You can CC a copy to me, so that'll be easier for me to show. And these two girls, they look like twins. They are. This is Leela and this is Meera. And just as I conclude, I'll tell you their story. I was in Loni again. And we